my name is Lila Bashan. I'm a development professional with almost 20 years of experience, and everything I talk about are my own personal views, not the position of the U.S. government. Today, I'd like to talk about five things to consider when applying for a job. I remember when you're first starting out on your career, getting a job is the most important thing, and it can be intimidating. But I have some tips for you to consider to hopefully reduce your anxiety and increase your expectations. So tip number one when you're applying for a job is to consider whether the position will challenge you. You know, when you're first starting out, it's inevitable that you're going to have to do tasks that aren't completely fascinating and amazing. Granted, throughout your career, sometimes you have to do things that aren't completely fascinating and amazing. But the important thing is that there are also tasks and responsibilities that are fascinating and that are challenging and help you grow as a professional. So don't apply for jobs that you could do in your sleep. Apply for jobs that help you grow because that's how you eventually advance in your career. So apply for a job that you're not 100% qualified for. Who knows, you might be more qualified than anyone else applying for the job. Like, don't apply for a job that's like 1,000 times more years of experience than you have or something like that, but do stretch yourself and challenge yourself and look for interesting jobs. My second suggestion is to look for an institution that seems to have a good work culture. You know, some institutions are large, some are bureaucratic, some are innovative, some expect you to be chained to your desk 24/7. Others are small and really encourage a work-life balance. So ask around. Even ask in your interview, if you get an interview, ask people you know who have worked there. Look online at resources that talk about different work culture, like Glassdoor. Find out if it's going to be a good fit for you. Because if you do end up working there and it's not a good fit, you can always try to create positive change to the work culture from inside the organization. Or you can just tough it out and work there for a little bit and then find an institution that's a better fit for you. The third thing to consider are whether your documents are in order. When applying for a job, you'll have to have a resume and a cover letter and maybe even sometimes a writing sample. So make sure that your resume is awesome. Have a friend or a trusted colleague or teacher read it through. Make sure there's consistency in grammatical use, like the Oxford comma. Make sure periods, if you use periods, you use them consistently. Make sure the tense is correct. Make sure it's not too long. You know, with almost 20 years of experience, my resume still kept to 2 pages. And so you really, like 10 years, keep it to 1 page. You don't want it to be too long because people have to look at lots of resumes. So keep it succinct and make sure there are not any errors on it. With the cover letter, I really suggest having a pretty standardized cover letter. I usually changed the first paragraph and the last paragraph of my cover letter and kept the middle part the same, but you change it and you tailor the first and the last paragraph, or at least part of it, to show the organization you're applying for that you know what job you're applying for and that you align the skills and experience you have with the requirements in the job description. But by having a standardized cover letter, it does mean that you can tweak it a little for each job, but that it won't take an extensive amount of time to rewrite it for each job you want to apply for. The fourth thing to consider is how wide do you want to throw your net? I say throw it as wide as possible. I once heard that for every job you apply for every 20 jobs you apply for, you're lucky if you get one interview. And of course, even if you get the interview, you don't necessarily get the job. So apply for as many jobs as possible. A good reason to have a pretty standardized cover letter so that you can send out more jobs. You know, if there's an organization you really want to work for, stalk their job opening page, or look at job boards, or in the first annex of my book, Global and Extraordinary Guide for Ordinary Heroes, my first annex has a long list of awesome international jobs to work at in different sectors, private sector, foundations, NGOs, multilateral organizations. So check that out, and also in the description of this video, I'll include some other job sites to look at. So apply, apply, apply. The worst you'll get is no response, and the best you'll get is an awesome job. And the fifth thing to consider is whether you're ready. You know, of course you're ready because you want a job and you've been applying for, but some things to consider before getting a job are, for one, clothes. Of course you have clothes, but do you have the right clothes? You know, when I first started interning at Mercy Corps, 20 years ago, I was a poor college student and I went to the thrift store to get what I thought were professional clothes, but my supervisor informed me that my skirts were a little too short and tight, and so I had to evolve my wardrobe to what was considered by my peers and my colleagues to be more professional. So you learn. And when I started at the State Department 14 years ago, by then my skirts had gotten looser and longer, but then I needed suits. And so I had to go out. Luckily, Filene's basement had lots of affordable suits. And honestly, still 14 years later, I'm still wearing a lot of them. I have not matured my wardrobe more past those suits that I got 14 years ago. So that's something to consider. Do you have the right clothes? Another thing to consider is you have to mentally prepare to be in the same place every day, all day. This might seem silly, but when I first started working at Interaction during grad school, I remember it was kind of a shock because I'd been so spoiled by my awesome grad school schedule where, you know, I had maybe a class or two every day and lots of time to do homework, lots of freedom in my schedule. And so having to be somewhere 8-9 hours a day was an adjustment. So it's just good to become mentally prepared for that. And then you might have to be prepared for a commute or even to move abroad. But you know what? Hold on, because it is an awesome, amazing ride and it's all totally worth it. So those are my five things to consider. Please subscribe. If you have a comment or question, please leave it in the comment section and know that you are on your way.